In our previous lessons, we have been discussing about animals, and under animals, we have already tackled about adaptation in animals. And in adaptation in animals, there is the feeding habits of animals and also adaptation of animals. Under feeding habits of animals, we say that mammals are divided into three groups according to their feeding habits. These are herbivorous, carnivorous, and omnivorous. Under adaptation of animals to movement, we say that animals move for various reasons. We say that animals move to search for food. Animals also move for shelters, to escape from enemies or predators, to search for favorable environmental conditions. They also move to seek for mate and also migrate. Then, under adaptation of animals to movement, we say that animals are adapted to various movements. One is some of the kind of movement we discussed is about flying. Some animals are adapted to flying, others are adapted to swimming, others are adapted to hopping and leaping. Hopping and leaping. Animals that are adapted to flying, we say some of these animals are like birds. Animals that are adapted to swimming, animals that move by swimming, some of them are like fish. We have the whale, we have the dolphin. Animals that are adapted to movement, which is by hopping and leaping, we have there. We have locusts, crickets, kangaroos. Those are animals that move by hopping and leaping. In today's lesson, we shall discuss the sign of ill health in livestock and also the effect of livestock diseases. Effects of livestock diseases. So, effect of livestock diseases. Are the signs of ill health in livestock? Through observing, you can be able to know whether an animal is healthy or it is, or whether that animal is not feeling well, ill health. So how can you know? By observing, through observation. So any changes that interferes with the normal functioning or normal function of the body organ or system, and system is called a disease. Any change that interferes with normal function of body organ and system is called a disease. It is a disease or an ill health. An ill health in an animal can be known easily through observing various signs. You can know an ill health animal through observing various signs. And some of these signs that we are going to discuss. Some of these signs are one is stunted growth. A sign of an ill health. One that we are going to discuss is stunted growth. What is stunted growth? This is whereby an animal grows slowly. An animal which, or animals which are sick or attacked by animals parasites do not feed well. When an animal is sick or whether it is attacked by a parasite or an animal parasite, it do not feed well. Therefore, their growth may slow down. For example, an adult animal may look smaller and thinner than other healthy animals of the same age. That's what we call stunted growth. Whereby, for example, maybe an animal of 1 year, it is supposed to be big and healthy. In this case, where the stunted growth, the animal, if it has the or this side, the animal will look smaller and thinner. This means a sick animal may not grow to full size. The sick animal will not grow to full size and therefore becoming stunted. This is what we refer to as stunted growth, where animals do not grow or where an animal may not grow to the full size. And I've said, for instance, an animal of an age of 1 year, it will look bigger. But whether if it has this size, it will look smaller and thinner. Stunted growth. This is one sign of an ill health. And you have said this size, these are signs that you can directly observe in an animal. Another sign is loss of weight. Loss of weight. Another sign of an ill health is loss of weight. Loss of weight. When an animal is sick, it will lose or it will lose appetite. When an animal is sick, it loses appetite. And it also becomes restless. It will lose appetite. For instance, it will not be able to feel well. Another one is that it will lose appetite. It will become restless. Therefore, you may observe that the animal, it will maybe have few movements during the day. Restless, it is unable even to feed well. Another one is that lack of proper feeding may lead to weakness of the body, that the animal, thus the animal loses weight. And this sudden loss of weight is a sign of ill health. This sudden loss of weight is a sign of ill health. So we are saying some of the sign of ill health is stunted growth, and we have discussed about stunted growth. Another one is loss of weight. You will observe, maybe the animal, the way you view it, it has started losing weight. It is a sign of an ill health animal. And we are saying, when an animal is sick, it will not be able to feed well, then the animal will become restless. The lack of proper feeding may lead to weakness of the body, thus the animal losing weight. And this sudden loss of weight, it is a sign of an ill health. Another one that we are going to discuss is reduced weight. Yield. Reduced yields. So, reduced yields. What is this? Good health in animals ensures maximum production of high quality yields. Good health in animals. It ensures maximum production of high quality yields. For instance, maximum production of high quality of yields, such as meat, milk, the eggs, and wool. So, unhealthy animal will give poor yields. When an animal is not feeding well, it will give poor yields. And ill health also, for ill health animal, also lowers the work output in animals such as donkey. We have other animals that help us work. We have the donkeys, we have the oxen, we have the horses. So, when an animal is not feeding well, in this case, for instance, the donkeys and the oxen and the horses, they lower the work output. Another sign sign of an injured animal is lab coat. We have the lab coat. The lab coat. A healthy animal. We have the lab coat. A healthy animal has a smooth and a clean coat. A healthy animal, it has a smooth and a clean coat. So when an animal is not feeling well or when an animal is sick, the coat appears to be damp. When an animal is sick, the coat appears to be damp. Other animals, for instance, not all animals, some animals they have hair or feathers. Their hairs or feathers may fall off. They may fall off. So the coat becomes for an animal. We have said that an animal which is healthy, the coat will be smooth and clean. The coat will be smooth and clean. And we have seen that the hairs and feathers for an animal that is not, or for a sick animal, the feathers will fall off. So the coat of us, or the coat of a sick animal, it becomes lab. It may also crack. It may also peel off. It may also become and develop wounds. If an animal is sick, the coat, it may be lab. It may also peel off. It may also crack. And these are things that you can directly observe in an animal. The coat becoming lab. It may crack. It may also peel off. And it may also develop some wounds. That is a sign of an ill health in animal. Lab coat. Another one is coughing. Another sign of an ill health animal is coughing. Another sign of ill health in animal is coughing. What is coughing? All animals, they have a mucous membrane. They have a mucous membrane. And during ill health, the membrane may secrete abnormal discharge or become dry. For instance, in a cow, the membrane, if a cow is not is sick, you may observe the mucus membrane and see that it may be dry. If the respiratory tract is infected, the animal cough. The animal will cough. Another one is blood. The blood in the tail. Blood in the stool. Blood in the stool. Blood in the stool. This is another sign of an ill healthy animal. Blood in the stool. Blood in the stool. This is the presence of blood in the blood stain in the stool. This is the presence of blood stain in the stool. So these are some of the signs of ill healthy in animal. We have said these signs are signs that you can directly observe them in an animal. One is stunted growth, whereby the animal grows slowly. This is a sign of ill health in an animal. One we have said is the stunted growth. Another one is loss of weight. You start seeing that maybe your cows or your goat or your sheep, they are losing weight. It is a sign of an ill health in animal. Another one is reduced yield. For example, your animals drag to produce maximum production of high quality, such as meat. We have the milk, we have the eggs and wool. Another one is lab coat. And I say for a healthy animal, the coat is smooth and clean. But if the animal is sick, the coat will be rough. It may even start cracking. It may peel off. You may also observe wounds in the coat. Another one about About another sign of ill health that we have discussed is coughing. We have said, where, for instance, animals react the mucous membrane. And if an animal is sick, the mucous membrane may be dry, may turn to be dry. Another one that we have already discussed is the blood in the stool. And you have said this is the presence of blood stain in the stool. Presence of blood stain in the stool. So those are some of the signs of ill health in livestock. So effect of livestock diseases. So, effects of livestock diseases include low yields. One is low yield. Diseases lead to reduced produce by animals. Whereby, for instance, a sick cow will give lower yield of milk or even stop production completely. So, for instance, you say that a sick cow, it will give lower yield of milk or even stop production completely. Another example is a sick hen. It will lay fewer eggs than it used to, or even if it can stop laying those eggs completely. Another one is a sick donkey or an oxen. It will offer less services compared to the services that it used to offer when it was healthy. So, one is the lower yield. This is where a disease or diseases will lead to lower, or it will lead to produce. Animals will reduce produce by. This is where we have said that lower yield. This is where an animal reduces the production. And we have said, for instance, is a sick cow. It may give lower milk production, or even stop the production completely. Another one is a sick hen. A sick hen will lay fewer times, or it can probably stop laying completely. A sick donkey or an oxen or a horse, it may give less services. Another one is death of animal. Death. Another effect of livestock diseases is death. If the animal is sick, it may lead to death of animal. If livestock is not treated, they can cause death. If you don't treat your animal, if sick, this may lead to death. Although some livestock diseases lead to sudden death of the affected animal. So it is good if the animal is not feeling well, it is good for you to treat that animal immediately. And you see, those are diseases that attack the animal. They may lead to sudden death of the affected animal. And in case the animal died, an animal which dies of disease should be burnt completely or buried deep in the ground to prevent diseases from spreading to healthy animals. So, in instance, or if the animal is affected by a certain disease, then it die. It is good for you to bury that animal deep in the ground or burn that animal. Why? To prevent the disease from spreading to the other healthy animal. Another one is reduced quality of product. Reduced quality. Or the product. Reduced quality of product. Reduced quality of product. Reduced another effect of livestock disease. If this animal is affected by certain disease, it may reduce the quality of product. It may reduce the quality of product. Livestock disease affect the quality of the product in these ways. For instance, the quality of the milk produced will be very low. The quality of the milk produced reduced quality of product. Therefore, and you have said that livestock diseases affect the quality of the product in the following way. For instance, we have the quality of the milk produced will be very low. The quality of the meat produced, it will also be very low. And also the quality product will be having low market value. They have very low market value. For instance, for example, if you want to sell a cow, we have a healthy cow and a cow that is suffering from a certain disease. Maybe it has black coat, maybe it has some of these signs that we have discussed. The healthy cow, it will be bought at a higher price. But the animal or the cow that it has the various signs that we have already discussed, it will be bought at a very low price. So the low quality product have low market value, and they are therefore not profitable to the farmer. For instance, if you want to sell milk of a healthy animal and a milk of an ill health animal, the milk of a healthy animal, it will be bought at a very high price. But if the animal it has ill health signs, it will be bought at a very low price. So the quality product have low market value and therefore leading to not profitable. The farmer will have no profit. Another one is transmission of diseases to human beings. Another effect of livestock disease. It is transmission of diseases to human beings. Transmission of diseases to human beings. So, human beings, as people, we may suffer from diseases by feeding on product of diseased livestock. We as human beings, if we feed from product of an animal that was suffering from various diseases, we may also be affected. So human beings may suffer from diseases by feeding on product of diseased livestock. Another side or another effect of livestock disease is high production cost. High production cost. High production cost. In which way? Due to administration or drugs to cure diseases. A farmer will spend a lot of money in trying to cure that animal by buying those diseases. It will cost the farmer, therefore, leading to higher production cost. Another one is, another effect of livestock disease is low income to the farmer. Low income to the farmer. This is due to low yield and high cost of production. Low income to the farmer. For instance, if an animal is healthy, it will produce a lot of milk. It will also produce, maybe, for instance, if it is a hen, it may produce very many eggs. But if the animal is suffering from certain disease, it is the milk will lower, the egg production will lower, the product will lower. For instance, if it is a donkey, the work output or the services offered by the donkey will be minimal. So, therefore, leading to low income to the farmer. Maybe a certain farmer used to sell the milk, and the animal is affected by various diseases, or it may suffer from the diseases that we have already discussed. Their milk production will be very low. So those are some of the effects of livestock diseases. And this effect, we have said, we have the low yield. This is where the production of the animal lowers. It may become low. We also have the death of the animal. If an animal is suffering from various diseases, it may die. And you have seen some various, so if not, and if it may die, if it is suffering from a certain disease, though in some diseases you can treat an animal and it may be okay. Though there are some diseases that lead to sudden death to animals. Another one is reduced quality of the product. It means if an animal is suffering from a certain disease, the quality of the product will be very low. Another one is transmission of diseases to human beings. This is where, for instance, a human being may suffer from disease by various diseases by feeding on product of disease and diseased livestock. Another one is high production cost. This high production cost, this is due to administration of cost or administration of drugs to cure the animal. Another one is the low income to the farmer. Low income to the farmer due to lower yield and high cost of production. This is due to lower yield and high cost of the production. So these are some of the, we have discussed signs, some of the signs of ileana in animals and also the effect of livestock diseases. And we are saying that these signs of ill health in animals, these are signs that you can observe. You can observe an animal that has a stunted growth, an animal that it is not growing well or into full size, loss of weight, reduced yield, lab coat, stunted growth, effect, blood in the stool. We have said blood in the stool, this is presence of blood stain in the stool. Effect of livestock diseases, we have seen some of the effect is low yield, we have death of animals, we have reduced quality of product, transmission of diseases to human beings, we have the high product cost and also the low income to the farmer, low income to the farmer. So those are some of the signs of ill health in animals and also the effect of livestock diseases. Those are some of the signs of ill health in animals and also the effect of livestock diseases. You may be asked, of the following is not an effect of livestock disease? Which one of the following is not an effect of livestock disease? We have already discussed. One is low yield is not an effect of livestock disease. Low yield. The second one is reduced quality product. The third one is death of an animal. Another one is meat inspection. Which one of the following is not an effect of livestock disease? A. Low yield or lower yield. B. You have the reduced quality production or product. C. We have death of an animal. D. Meat inspection. The answer is meat inspection. Meat inspection. Another question. Which one of the following is a sign of ill health in an animal? Which one of the following is a sign of ill health in an animal? We have A. We have reduced yield. We have the body temperature, appetite. Which one of the following is a sign of ill health in an animal? We have A. We have reduced yield. We have B. We have the body temperature. C. We have appetite. Among the three, which one is a sign of an ill health in an animal? I know, Lana, you have already answered. This time we check whether you have gotten it right. And then, among the three, a sign of ill health in animal is reduced yield. It is reduced yield. Another question you may be asked. A diseased animal shows the following signs except. A diseased animal shows the following signs except. A. We have stunted growth. B. We have stool or blood in stool. C. We have loss of appetite. And D. Camouflage. A. We have stunted growth. B. We have blood in stool. C. We have loss of appetite. D. We have camouflage. A diseased animal shows the following signs except. I know you have already answered. So, among the four, a diseased animal will show three of them. That is, stunted growth, blood in the stool, and loss of appetite. But camouflage is not an answer. And what is camouflage? Camouflage. This is the ability of an animal to change its skin. It is the ability of an animal to change its skin color to match with that of the environment. Another question. Name six signs observed when an animal is ill. One, you have the stunted growth, loss of weight, we have reduced yield, we have coughing, blood in the stool, loss of appetite, discharge from the mouth, we have discharge from the nose, our lining nose, we have also the change of temperature. It may be high or low. So those are some of the signs observed when an animal is sick. You may also be asked to name four effects of ill health in animals. You may also be asked to name the effect of ill health in animals. You may name them. We have already discussed, and I know you know you have already named them. So that was our lesson. We have already discussed about the signs of ill health and effect of livestock diseases. And I know, Lana, you have understood. And if you have any question, you may ask to the maybe to a teacher near you, or you may also ask to your friend. So, thank you, Nana, for listening. Till next time, bye.